Hey everyone, have you seen the video with this woman that was a nurse at this Utah hospital? There's three parameters set out that are deemed a necessity if you're wishing to draw blood from a patient. And this nurse was basically following the law to a T and actually said to the officer in charge, or the officer involved in this particular instance that's in this video, she was saying, hey, listen, you know, we can't do it. That's just, it's against the law, and it's against not just the law, but it's against our policy. So, yeah, we can't do it. But what did the officer do? He arrested her.
Brad, I'm just putting on speaker so you can. So, I have this. It says obtaining blood samples for police enforcement from patients suspected to be under the influence. Okay? This is something that you guys agree to with this hospital. The three things that allow us to do that are if you have an electronic warrant, patient consent, or patient under arrest. And neither of those things, the patient can't consent. He's told me repeatedly that he doesn't have a warrant and the patient is not under arrest. So I'm just trying to do what I'm supposed to do. That's all. So.
Okay, so I take it without those in place, I'm not going to get blood. Is that, am I fair to surmise that?
Alex, you're not representing.
Yeah,
okay.
I don't know. I have no idea why he's blaming me. I'm just representing.
Why are you blaming the messenger, sir?
She's the one that has told me no.
Yeah, but sir, you're making a huge mistake right now.
Okay. Okay. No, we're done. We're done. You're under arrest. We're going. We're done.
Not a thing.
I said we're done.
Behold, Salt Lake City Police Detective Jeff Payne arresting nurse Alex Wubbles in July for refusing to violate an unconscious, comatose actually, man's rights by drawing his blood for the police without any sort of warrant whatsoever. What Payne did here is patently, inescapably wrong in just about every possible way. Just 1 year ago, the Supreme Court ruled that police must get a warrant or consent in order to draw a person's blood. It's utterly inconceivable that Payne, who is a trained phlebotomist with the police, did not know this. According to coverage from the Salt Lake Tribune, Payne acknowledged that he didn't have probable cause to get a warrant, but nevertheless insisted he had the authority to demand Wobbles draw blood. But Payne did not have the authority to demand the blood draw, and Wobbles was not interfering with a police investigation, as they insist at the time. Unsurprisingly, she was released later at the hospital and was not charged with any crime. Of course. In fact, the claim that his blood draw was part of an investigation at all adds another layer of revulsion to Payne's behavior. The unconscious man Payne wanted blood from was not suspected of any crime and had not done anything wrong. He was, in fact, a victim of a crime. So I'll post a link to this article in the description of the video below. But once again, we're seeing time and time and time and time and time again. Matter of fact, if I wanted, I could spend every day and make every video about the kind of vile and despicable, illegal, immoral, and unjust behavior just from the enforcers, the mindless enforcers of the state, or the political or media pundits, right? I could literally make a 24-hour news program, basically, based solely on pointing out the hypocrisy, the discrepancies, the illegal, immoral, and unjust actions and behaviors of all those that's supposed to be the public servants, that are supposed to be serving you, the people, right? That's the whole premise of the social contract, of the social construct, is they're supposed to serve you. Their ability to get a paycheck is supposed to be reliant completely on them holding to a certain principle, on certain standards. That means that they are not the owners or the rulers, right, of the people, right? They're supposed to be the servants that carry out the orders of the people. and respect the principles and philosophy contained within the document, so whether it's the Constitution or a Bill of Rights. But as we're seeing, they manipulate, they distort, they use legalese and high-paid lawyers to completely negate human rights, individual rights, and proper laws, morals, and ethics, right? The kind of things that are the very fabric of a free society. It's being underhanded and undermined continually. I hope this gentleman's not just fired. I hope he's charged criminally for what he's done, right? Let him be on the other side for once and see what it's like. Skidane Libertarian, and I love liberty.